Hey, there we are. Shut up,
Dennis. Good boy. Ah, got you.
Master fade out.
Oh, yeah, that was awesome. All right. We got a lot of good shit coming up. I'm not going to waste any more time. This may be the only band that didn't have to like work and put the band back together. These guys have been doing it continuously for years and years and years. Let's hear it for the Troublemakers.
Get out of my head. You will not. can confirm, this is not a reunion show. We have just been going nonstop since 1993. And, of course, Jerry has been one of the big reasons for that, and we'd like to say thanks to him and everyone who put this together. He is smart enough to not be watching us right now.
Yeah, I'm looking for Mr. Perry. Last band, he was right in front of the stage.
That band was good, right?
So...
because your guitar's going to melt his
face. A likely excuse.
This is yet another song we didn't write.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. Rick. No, they told us you're playing early. Play some crapola. So those of you like Alex who have seen us like 100 times before will know that this is the part of the show where we have technical difficulties. We'll be revisiting this part a bunch. It's a song off our first record, which we released 22 years ago.
Oh, young sugar out the spider. Now I look left me, pulling out my hair. Just lost all my money. I'm just playing so damn good. We'll be right back.
Thank you very much. We just got a couple more. Thank you. This will be technical difficulty number two for those keeping track.
Right? Who's counting?
I also spell weed. I think you should say that for the Kaiko and Choli.
Second time starts with you.
Yeah. amazing. It's a pretty low body count on broken shit up here for the Troublemakers, but all right. Brian McKenna wants me to have you know that on January 11th, right here, the losing streaks, which are losing streaks, the losing streaks, sorry, are gonna be back with the Decibels and the Snobs of all things. So come back on January 11th for that. So seeing everybody here is bringing up all kinds of trips down this memory lane, and seeing Stan reminded me of a story, and it's gonna probably drive Jerry crazy because I'm gonna get details wrong. But one time at the Cattle Club, we were loading stuff in late on a Thursday night for a Friday night show with Pigface. And I walked out to the truck with John Renoir, who was here. And Stan had just stopped by for no reason at all. He was not involved with either show, and he and Jerry were inside. Well, some skinhead showed up, as, you know, bound to happen at the Cattle Club in the 90s. Anyway, by the time I walked back in, the skinheads were rushing out. They punched me in the face, which I thought was kind of bad, until I walked in and saw Jerry laying on the ground and Stan, who was bleeding profusely. Long story short, Stan's jaw had to be wired shut. Jerry had broken bones in his back. Oh, good times, the Cattle Club. And all I got was a bloody nose and a broken glasses.